Can you hear me now?
Yeah, there we go.
Yes? Can you hear me?
Yes or no?
Nice. Okay. Yeah. So you were asking before, what am I building, basically? Cool. So I don't know. My original intent with like doing the live streaming stuff was like I'm working on all these side projects all the time, and I figured like I might as well just live stream them while I'm working on them. One of the ones I was working on was a flight detection algorithm, like it was like cheap flights basically. What it was doing, it was like scanning an API every so frequently and would like check the current price of a flight versus the previous, like the historical price, and if it was an outlier, I was planning on like maybe sending it to an email or something and maybe creating an email list for these or something like that, which we could still work on that, but I was like, well, I got this other idea to do like a Twitter bot for like a Christian Twitter bot because I found this API a while back and I made a note of it and was like, hey, now I wonder if I could maybe do a Twitter bot for this. And then after I thought about the Twitter bot, I was like, well, could you maybe, this is kind of stupid, but could you maybe do one of these for every religion, not just Christianity, and like create a bunch of Twitter bots and see which one is like the most popular, right? So that's kind of what I decided to work on, even though I think the other one's probably a better business idea. Like I could probably make money off of it. I still thought this one was like an interesting idea, and so I started building it. So right now what I'm doing is I'm just okay, it's hard because like you came in halfway through the development. Basically what I have is I've got these the list of books and chapters in the Bible. So if you look at the API, you'll see that the like kind of like what the guy expects from the API request is the name of the book and then the chapter and the verse. And when I found when I was like messing around, if you look earlier in the stream, I don't know if that's even possible, but you can see like I started out just like curling his API and wanted to see like what is the behavior. What I found is like if you just send the book in the chapter, you can get any sort of verse, right? So then I went on GitHub and found all these, the list of books and chapters, and I was like testing these to make sure that these formats work with the API and all this stuff. Turns out they do. And so basically what the code's doing right now is I'm taking the books over here, right, that I showed you already in the map, and I'm just picking a random book out of that. So my idea is for the Twitter bot is just going to like maybe every hour or so, just randomly. I think I'll put this in like a Lambda or maybe even a Pi with a cron tab or something like that, depending on how much time I have to work on the side project. But what I'm thinking is it just like periodically, maybe once every hour, is it will just trigger this script and then send a request to the Twitter API to like tweet one of these verses. I kind of want to see like if there will be any engagement from just like random random Bible verses, I guess. So that's what I'm working on right now. But this is kind of stupid though, because like I was hoping like it would be more interactive while I was working on this. Like I don't even know when you're commenting back to me, right? So it's like hard for me to code at the same time and like interact with people. So I don't know how much I'm actually going to keep doing these live streams. They seem kind of. Also, it's like one thing I noticed while I was working on this is like it's hard to give people context in the middle of a like you kind of have to code with people so that way like if they happen on a live stream, right, it's like I don't know, they have no idea what you're working on in the middle. Like coding is so contextual that it's hard to like do it in a live stream fashion versus, maybe some other stuff that would be more like gaming, right? You don't if you happen on a gaming live stream, you would just be like Oh, he's playing Overwatch, and I can watch you play Overwatch. And I don't need to know what happened in the previous game or what's going to happen in the future games in order to enjoy watching someone play Overwatch. But with this, it's like you kind of have to have all this context to see what I'm doing. So I probably won't keep live streaming just because I've learned a couple lessons from it already this time. But if you haven't subscribed already, then I would recommend subscribing. You could see there's a bunch of yeah, I probably should. Maybe that would help that I'd be able to like live stream like code on one side and then check the chat on the other side, maybe. I don't know. But what I was saying is like I've got a bunch of videos like where I go through a bunch of coding stuff that are more polished, I guess you could say, than doing this live stream stuff. But anyway, so I'm gonna get back to it. Yeah, I guess it does suck, right? I can't even talk to you right now while I'm coding. That's another thing. It's like gaming, I can sit and BS while I'm playing the game because it doesn't take that many brain cells. But with coding, it's like I have to focus on the code I'm writing rather than talking. So it's like less entertaining too. So anyway, back at it, back at it. Where was I? Oh, I remember. So the thing I was doing was I was getting a verse. So what I found is like if I grab a random verse, I also have all this extra context inside the, like he returns a nice little JSON object inside the verse. So I wanted to print out like, 'cause I'm guessing my Twitter bot would want to say something like Thessalonians 3:12 or whatever, right? Currently, all I was printing out was the verse, so I was like, okay, I also need the. I guess he also gives the book name and the chapter, so I could use that from the request itself. So this really is like verse metadata, not necessarily the verse itself. And then just grab that out of it. Stupid thing. Except this is getting pretty long. Of course, Python can't do that. Then the actual text. I need to fix that line. It's getting too long. What's he complaining about? How do you do you know how to split the text into new lines in Python? Like, guessing something like that would work. Probably, hopefully. And I can't even see you, so I don't even know. Oh, so you're like OG. You're OG from like back when I was doing the EOS stuff. Okay, cool. Awesome. Glad you've stuck around this long. It's been a while. I haven't been doing any of the EOS stuff. I need to update that course, but I just haven't gotten around to it. Why isn't that working? Some stupid. I've got to be missing something very stupid. What the heck? Oh, duh, of course. It's always something stupid. There we go. And now we should be able to split that line back up like I wanted to before. Still is like kind of too long for my taste, but oh well. Nice. Okay, so we've got this little script. I'm wondering what I should, if I should set up the Twitter account or get this running on a cron tab instead. I think probably the Twitter account's gonna be the most difficult part. Yeah, I guess I'll do that. The problem is like, oh yeah, you saw me. There we go. Yeah, see, it's like, I can't even get help. All right, I definitely need it. Actually, my wife's screen's sitting right here. Maybe, all right, let me plug this other screen in. If I can, oh, it doesn't work with Mac. Because I'm thinking like, I might be able to get a second screen on and actually see what people are saying. It's like amateur hour, dude. For me, I can't, I've never done this before, so I'm not prepared at all. Yeah, I noticed the latency as well. It's kind of, it's not ideal. But, okay, let's see what happens if I do this. I've never even used this screen before, so I'm guessing. That's gonna have problems. Oh, sweet. Okay. So if I move this over here. What's going on? Alright, I gotta look into setting up the screen now. Separate screens. Do you know how to do that on Mac? Like, get two screens going so that this one, like, for some reason, it's streaming the entire thing even though I have this second screen set up. Actually, I wonder if it's. No, that's not it. Oh, yeah, cool. Wait, did that work? No, it did not work. I bet you this is like in the. Let's see if this is in the. What happened? Get out of here. In the streaming settings, like for the software. Where I have to like tell it which screen that I wanna. Yeah, let's see. Let's see if this, what happens if I do this. Did it work? Let's see what's happening. Oh no, I lost him. Come on. Nice. Okay, cool. Okay. And then let's see if like I can still use my terminal if that will show up. This latency is brutal. Oh man, seriously? No? What's going on? This latency is like 1 minute. How do I fix that? Okay, cool. Yeah. This should work, other than this latency is terrible. I'll have to. It looks like I can't change the latency right now, but maybe for the next one, I'll make a note that this is so bad. Okay, cool. All right, now it's fixed. So we can get back to coding. Okay, so yeah, the next thing I was planning on doing was this Twitter integration, I think. What I don't like about this, though, is like, I kind of wanted to everybody to see like what I'm Googling as well, which maybe if I pull this over here. Would that work? Let's see. It's like now we gotta wait a day until the latency shows up and we know just how bad this is. Come on, stupid thing. Yeah, okay, cool. So I still should be able to Google things so people can see. Because I want everyone to be able to see, like, you know, what I'm Googling while I'm coding too. Because I think that's kind of a useful thing. Oh, except it's like only showing half the screen. Oh well, that will do for now. It's still the first live stream. We're running into all sorts of technical difficulties. This should work for now, though. Yeah, exactly. Like everybody's Googling while they're coding. So, and like to be quite honest, like even at work, people are like sometimes they come up behind me, look at my screen, and they're like, I Google the most simple like stuff on the planet. Like, I think, what was I Googling? How to get the left side of a pear in Java or something when somebody came up behind me the other day and was like, dude, you have to Google that. It's, I feel like software engineering is less about the syntax and more about thinking through problems and edge cases and things like that. So, I don't know. You'll see that I'm gonna Google like the most basic stuff. But in this case, I want to get my developer account on Twitter, so that I can start. Actually, what we should do is create the account first, I think. Which I don't even know how to do that. Wonder. I wonder what to name this account. It's got to be something catchy. Probably need to log out of my personal account. There we go. What do we call this?
I didn't want to think about this until the end of the project when I was like more concerned with.
I know what I'll do. I'll just use my personal account to test it, and then we'll name it something and use a different account later. Hopefully that's like something we can change at a later date. I'll just warn all my Twitter followers that this is going on. No. I will say this about live streaming. It's fun. It's funner than coding alone. Like, to have at least, like, I know you're just one dude or woman or whatever. It's a little bit weird talking to a stranger, but it's also funner, I think. Even though I'm having all these technical difficulties on the first live stream, it's still funner than just coding by yourself. So I'd recommend it. Like, if you have a YouTube channel, do some live streaming. And also leave me your link so that I can subscribe to your YouTube channel or something like that. If not, you know, no big deal. Okay. One thing I was thinking about before I started the live stream, though, is I don't want people to see my API key, which I obviously need in order to build this bot. So I might have to turn the live stream off momentarily while I get the API key set up. Because obviously Twitter's not going to like it if my API key is streamed all over YouTube. So I'm gonna have to turn this off momentarily and start it back up again after I have the API key set up. But let me see. I might actually have to do that now. Because I'm worried that if I scroll down on the page, they're gonna show my API key. And then that will be the end of it, and there's nothing I can do about it. Okay, so let me end the stream for now. Get the API key set up and like push to a separate account, and then I'll start the stream back up after I've hidden the API key somewhere in the project. And then hopefully I don't accidentally open it back up again or something like that. All right, see you in just a second.